Okay, I'm here at my familiar, reliable southbound spot, and everything is covered in wet, shitty snow. I was pretty much panting just from getting over here, walking through it with a backpack. Hopefully my train is long when it pulls up, because if I have to chase it too far down that way, the crew change here is really quick oftentimes. It's possible I can miss it, just trying to get down there with the snow.
So what is the dealio?
Well, this is my normal southbound spot, and you can even go north from here too. This fan conveniently melts the snow during the winter, so it's a good spot because of that. I've been working for $10 per hour at an auto parts store for the past couple months, and it sucks, you know, driving around town with the snow and a two-wheel drive, dropping off auto parts all day, 5 days per week. So yeah, I'm just ready to get out of here. I'm going down to California. It's been pretty wet down there too, but I think we're finally about to like come into springtime more, and it should be getting warmer. So I'm gonna hang out with my buddies. I've got places I can stay. I'm really not planning on doing a whole lot other than being down there and enjoying myself. Truthfully, I've been traveling on an agenda way more than I would like, or more than I want to be lately. It seems every time I'm out here riding trains, I have somewhere to be and something to do, and deadlines.
Somebody's in there.
Anyway, but not this time. This time, this is strictly just to be out there and enjoy myself. And I'm really not... Yeah, it's gonna be hanging out. Well, I just put my bibs on. And they are wonderful. Highly recommended. I can sit down now, pretty much. And I'm way comfortable. And most importantly, as you can see here, I still look cool.
Whoa.
Crikey. I was kind of unsure whether or not I would really want these once I got down to California, and I almost backed out on bringing them. But they're not very heavy, and I'm glad I brought them. And when I get down to California, like on the train or in Oakland or whatever, I mean, it's warm enough there all winter. I'll pretty much just be able to like put these on and sleep anywhere I want to. And I won't have to get out my bedroll, which will be pretty cool. Because finding a spot in Oakland can be pretty tricky. I do have a buddy there who I'm going to see. So hopefully it won't come to that. But you never know. A lot of times I end up at places at random hours and have to wait. So, there's that. Yeah. Other anticipated stops for California include the Oakley Antioch area to hang out with a fellow houseless tramp gentleman. So I've been wanting to ride the Dago, the line to San Diego. Only the portion from LA on, though. You know, I have all month, and I wanted to go ride the P-Vine, but I think with, that's another tidbit. There is a special international event, an event of international proportions. So yeah, I'm not gonna go ride the P-Vine, but I think I will try to go down to Colton or LA, hang out down there for a minute, maybe go be a beach bum for a couple days. That's pretty fun sometimes. And ultimately catch that train down to San Diego for the hell of it. I hear from a rail fan friend or acquaintance in Colton that it's borderline worth it. There are apparently only like 5 minutes where you're actually on the coast going down to San Diego, and you do have to ride through an Air Force base, which apparently could be sketchy. I've been through military bases before and it's always worked out okay, but you never know. It's kind of a hassle in some ways, but given that I have all month, I'm gonna do that.
Weather moving in. It's been pretty nice so far today. Yesterday was pretty much a bluebird day, but I think we're gonna get more snow. Not a lot, but 4 hours. I hear a train coming in. I was getting kind of worried that they weren't gonna do anything on the weekend, which has happened before, but looks like I'm gonna be good to go. That's what I'm talking about.
I'm on the train.
back east this day's leaving home every day, beating the hot old dusty way to the California line. Across the desert sands they roll, getting out of that old dust bowl. They think they're going to a sugar bowl, but here's what they find.
California is very wet and green.
Now the police at the port of entry say,
and they need it.
You're number 14,000 for the day. Oh, if you ain't got the dough, ray me. You ain't got the dough, ray me. Why, you better go back to beautiful Texas, Oklahoma, Kansas, Georgia, Tennessee. California is a garden of Eden, a paradise to live in or see. But believe it or not, you won't find it so hot if you ain't got the dough, ray me. Buy you a home or farm that can't deal nobody harm, or take your vacation by the mountains or ski. Don't swap your old cow for a car, you better stay right where you are. You better take this little tip from me, 'cause I look through the want ads every day, but the headlines on the papers always say, if you ain't got the dough, ray me, boys. You ain't got the dough, ray me. Why, you better go back to beautiful Texas, Oklahoma, Kansas, Georgia, Tennessee. California is a garden of Eden, a paradise to live in or see. But believe it or not, you won't find
stop
it so
here.
Hot
stop
if you ain't
Sacramento.
Got the dough, ray
it's
me.
Really nice. California. Birds are chirping and singing, but now they hear me talking. Like I said, I'm just south of Sacramento. It's 12:15 in the afternoon, and I got on this train about exactly that time yesterday in Bend. And it's a pretty good time, you know, 24 hours from Bend, Oregon to Stockton, California. I've definitely taken the same train and had it take probably more like 32 hours or something, you know. So I'm happy about that. It snowed on me for most of the night, I think. I woke up early this morning and I had 2 or 3 inches of snow on me. And then, that once again, this has happened before, and every time. From Quincy, you pretty much begin losing elevation quickly, and the snow begins to melt rapidly, and by the time you're anywhere near the Central Valley, it's all turned to water and you're sopping wet. And that's what happened. But I've managed to dry out. It's not raining anymore today, hopefully. And I'm only like, you know, 30 miles from where I'm trying to get. So, yeehaw. And when I get to Stockton, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to find a Clamato.